Hello dear students, today we will be discussing the topic digital voltmeter and digital frequency meter. So digital voltmeter can be used to display the value of measured AC or DC voltage as discrete numerical signal instead of a pointed deflection or a continuous scale as in the case of analog instruments. Now the numerical readout is advantageous since it eliminates the observational errors. It also increases the speed with which a readings can be taken and it also can be stored. So this is a figure for a digital voltmeter where your display is in the form of digits. Now we'll look at the working of a DVM. A DVM consists of few sections. First one is attenuator section, then you have analog to digital converter, and then you have the converter signals in the form of pulses which can be read by a decade counter. So here we have a decade counter which counts the number of pulses, and then you have a 7-segment display available here which can display the digits. You have 3 set of displays available for least significant bit up to most significant bit. So this can each display can show up to 9, 0 to 9, so maximum value that can be read is 999, and here also provide the decimal point selected depending on the value of input voltage that can be that need to be shown. Now if your input voltage is very high in magnitude, attenuator section is used to reduce the value to the permissible value of the instrument. Now it reduces the value by a factor n depending on the resistances that you have. So at the point A, at the terminal A, you will get Vin as such. There is no attenuation. At point B, you will have a slight attenuation. And point C, you will have more attenuation. And the value, the attenuated signal that reaches the ADC input is converted to digital forms. Here, the resolution of the ADC is 1 millivolt per step. That simply means that for each millivolt, you will have one pulse generated. One pulse generated for each millivolt. So this corresponds to 1 millivolt. Here you have 1 millivolt. So here 4 pulses corresponds to 4 millivolt of input voltage. So in that way, this particular pulses can be counted, and that can be counted using a decade counter which counts the number of pulses. So that this is an electronic circuit which is used to count the pulses. So this pulses can be counted, and this counted pulses will be available at the output of the decade counter. So you have a 7447 interface which is used to convert the BCD signal, binary coded decimal signal, which is the output of the decade counter, to the interface of the 7-segment display. So here I'll explain the working of the decade counter in the next slide. So once you have the values available at the output of the decade counter, the 7447 IC is used to energize the different segments of this particular 7-segment display. If you are planning to show 1, you have to energize this section as well as this segment. If you are going for 7, you need to energize this and the other, these two. So you need to energize 3. So in that way, the elements, the segments that need to be energized, that is decided by the 7447 IC depending on the input values which are available from the decade counter. So decimal point selector is used to obtain the decimal points at different locations. If you are planning to, if your value is 9.99, your decimal point will be placed here. Okay, so in that way, your decimal point also can be changed depending on the range of the voltage that is being measured. Now we'll look at how the decade counter works. So your decade counter is works on the principle of counting the number of pulses. So here it is in the form of binary coded decimal. So your decimal values are converted to binary values 1 and 0, and here 0 corresponds to 0000. Here QD QC QB and QA corresponds to 4 flip flops which are again electronic circuits which helps in counting, which are part of this decade counter. So this decade counter can count up to 9, that is 10 steps it will be counting, and at the 11th step it will not go for 10, rather it will be resetting and it will be going for 0. And 9 will be corresponding to 1001, which is the binary value of this decimal and this digit 9. And once it reaches 9, the next, with the next pulse available, it will move to 0. This particular DC1 will be moving to 0, and this DC2 will be incremented by 1, so it will becomes 10. And again it counts from 0 to 9, so it reaches 19, and after 19 this DC1 will be incremented to 0 and this will be incremented to 2. Okay, in that way you are able to display different values. So everything happens so fast that you are able to obtain the output very quickly, just as the signal, that is just as the indication of the lighting up of this 7 segment display. Now this is a specific type of DVM, which is RAM type. So this depends on the measurement of time. Okay, so here you have input voltage being provided to the ranging and attenuator circuit, and after attenuation, which is a reduction of value, it is compared with the RAM signal that is generated by the RAM generator. Then that will be compared with the input value, and once the input voltage as well as the ramp voltage are equal, a start pulse is provided to the gate and the pulses will begin to pulses start emerging, and it will be sent to the counter for counting, and the counting will be continuing till the RAM signal will be equal to 0. That is, it will be compared with the ground value or ground comparator, and that gives a stop signal and the pulses are stopped, and the number of pulses are counted by the counter, which are displayed with the help of 7 segment display. Now here you can see that the RAM signal is the one that is used will be reducing in nature. You can go for a positive slope ramp also. Here we are making use of the RAM, which is having negative slope. You are making use of this section. So the input signal is here. Whenever the input signal and the RAM signal are equal, this is the first coincidence point or starting point, your pulses will be starting and this will be counted by the counter, and this will be continuing up to the point where your RAM becomes equal to 0, or this is the value point, which is the input voltage that needs to be measured. So whenever a RAM becomes equal to 0, you are reaching the total magnitude of the input signal. So the pulses will be available up to that point, and for a period of delta t time period, you are having n number of pulses. So that will be giving an indication of the voltage which is there at the input signal. So number of pulses gives an indication of the voltage. So this is how you make use of RAM type DVM to measure the voltage. Now the advantages of digital voltmeter include the numerical readout that are available, which eliminates observational errors. It also have better accuracy as well as versatility, and they have greater speed of taking the voltage reading as compared to analog instruments, and can be stored in the memory devices, and it is portable as the size of DVM is smaller when compared to the analog meter. Now we'll move on to the digital frequency meter. A digital frequency meter is a digital instrument that can measure as well as display the frequency of any periodic waveform. It works on the principle of gating the unknown input signal. So we'll explain what the process is, that is gating the unknown signal. Now you are providing the input signal to the input terminal. Here if your input signal is weak, you can amplify it. If your input signal is having high magnitude, you can attenuate it. So the periodic waveform that is available is passed through a wave shaping circuit, which is Schmidt trigger circuit. So once the signal is passed through the Schmidt trigger circuit, the amplified or attenuated input is converted to square pulses or shaped waveforms. So that is provided to the one of the inputs of AND gate. Now the second input of AND gate comes from a time-based circuit. So the time base signal will be generating a time base of 1 second, a square pulses of 1 second. So here you can see that you have a square pulse of 1 second, and you have a flip flop. So the time period of time base, the signal that is generated is 1 second. Then you have flip flop which converts this to half the frequency, that is into a time period of 2 seconds. Here you can see that Q, the Q signal is provided to AND gate. Q output is having a time period of 2 seconds. If this is 1 second, the entire time period this will be 1 second, and this also will be 1 second. So the total time period will be 2 seconds. So once the time period increases, the frequency is halved. So the purpose of flip flop V2 is to reduce the frequency by half. And Q will be a complementary output of Q bar. That is, if Q is equal to 0, Q bar will be equal to 1. And if Q is equal to 1, your Q bar will be equal to 0. So these are complementary outputs. Now, once the Q is provided to AND gate, the AND gate output will be 1 only once the two inputs are 1. For all other conditions, the AND gate output will be 0. So that simply means that whenever your Q is high, when Q is high, the pulses will be transferred to the output of the AND gate. These pulses will be transferred to the output of the AND gate. Now suppose you have, here you have three pulses, 1, 2, and 3 pulses within 1 second. So you'll have 3 pulses per second. So here you can see that you have 3 cycles per second. So 3 pulses per second is equal to 3 cycles per second, which is equal to 3 hertz. In that way, you are able to measure the frequency. Now, how does this entire process works? Here, for every square pulse, you have a leading trail as well as a falling trail. So this is your falling trail, and this will be your leading trail. Whenever your signal is reducing from high to low, it is a falling trail, falling edge, and this is leading edge, where your signal is increasing from 0 to 1. So at the, and your Q bar is, which is a complementary output of Q, is given to register as well as latch. The function is to start counting. Whenever your Q bar is at your falling edge, from Q bar is reducing from 1 to 0, your register starts to count the number of pulses. So from that point itself, the pulses will be arriving at the output of the AND gate, and that will be counted and stored in the register. And this will be continuing till your Q bar is increasing from 0 to 1. So at that point, your counting stops and your latch will be now sending the latch will be triggered, and this latch that will be allowing the values stored in the register to be transferred to the 7 segment display that is there at the output. So the values which are counted can be displayed easily at the output. Okay, so this is how the entire digital frequency meter works. So this is a detailed working. You can pause the video and you can go through the different points to understand better. And you are also provided with the option of changing the frequency range. That is, you'll be asked, you are given signal of 50 hertz, 500 hertz. So you need to measure both. How do you do that? So 50 hertz simply means that you have 50, you will be generating 50 pulses per second. So every second you are having 50 pulses. So that is the capacity of the DFM that you have. For every second you are able to, or every duration you are able to count 50 pulses. Whatever the duration of time base that you choose, you are able to count 50 pulses. Now if you need to count 500 pulses per second, that you may not be able to do it, because for a time period that is available, you are able to count only 50 pulses. So what you do is that you change the range to 100 millisecond. Okay, once you change the range to 100 millisecond, what happens? 100 millisecond is equal to 0.1 second. So if you are having 500 pulses per second, you will have 50 pulses per 0.1 second. So that is a new time base. you are changing the time base to a new value, 0.1 seconds. For every 0.1 second, you will have 50 pulses. So for 1 second, you will have 500 pulses. So that simply means that your frequency is 500 hertz. Okay, so that way, by changing the time base, you are able to measure different ranges of frequencies. As the frequency range is changing, the decimal point also changes depending on the value of frequency that you measure. So here you have 1.99 kilohertz, here 19 kilohertz, 199.9 kilohertz, and here you have 1.999 megahertz. So for different frequencies, your time base also varies. Here it is varying from 1 second to 1 millisecond. So depending on the time base that you choose, your decimal point also changes. See here, this particular point is taken by 2 steps. Here it is common for 1 second as well as 1 millisecond. But for 1 second it is kilohertz, for 1 millisecond here the range is megahertz. So in that way your display will be available. So this is how the frequency can be varied, range can be varied with the help of range can be varied and different frequencies can be measured with the help of digital frequency meter. Thank you.